لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم لا تزول قدم ابن آدم يوم القيامة حتى يسأل عن خمس عن عمره فيما أفناه وعن شبابه فيما أبلاه وعن ماله من أين اكتسبه وفيما أنفقه وعما عمل فيما علم أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه وأزواجه وذرياته الله سبحانه وتعالى has sent us into this world for a limited period of time. Some of us may stay in this world for 20 years, some for 25 years, some for 30 years, some for 37 years, some for 42 years. Some will go beyond 50, beyond 60, beyond 70, beyond 80. But a time will come when every human will have to depart from this world. This has been the culture all along. Right from Adam alayhi salatu was salam until today, until our forefathers, until our grandparents or great grandparents. Nobody has come in this world to live forever. There is only one person, the Rasul of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Isa alayhi salam, who has been raised up into the heavens. He has not died yet. But he too will return before the day of Qiyamah. And after returning, he will get married, he will have children, he will live a life of a normal human being with strict adherence to the teachings of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and eventually he will also die a natural death. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدِ. When the enemies of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, the mushrikeen of Makkah Mukarrama, the munkirin of Makkah Mukarrama, when they remarked and they said that, don't worry, for how long will he live? 60 years, 70 years, 80 years, 90 years. Sooner or later he will die. And with him his mission will also die. When these words fell in the ears of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam, our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam felt hurt. It's natural that when a person strives for the well-being of somebody, and that person is unable to understand and realize that this person is my benefactor, and instead of paying attention to him, and instead of listening to what he has to say, and instead of following his guidance, that person or those people oppose him. And not only oppose him, they criticize him. And not only criticize him, they wait for some calamity to befall him, or they wait for his death. So naturally a person feels hurt. Our beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam also felt hurt, who was striving day and night to bring each and every individual of Makkah Mukarrama onto the path leading to Jannah, everlasting bliss. And as a result, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam learns that they are waiting for me to die. So he felt hurt. And it was natural for Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to feel hurt. Allah jalla jalaluhu wa amma nawaluhu loved his Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam immensely. So whenever Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam felt hurt, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself would console him. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was consoled by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through this verse, وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدَ أَفَإِمْ مِتَّ فَهُمُ الْخَالِدُونَ. O my Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are already aware that sooner or later you will depart from this world. And they are also saying the same thing. But is it that you are going to depart one day and they are going to remain in this world forever and ever? وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدِ. We have not decreed for any human to remain in this world for eternity. We have not decreed this for any human. Neither for a disbeliever, neither for an idolater, nor for a person who is disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or a wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or a nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Afayim mitta, if you will die, fahumul khalidun, will they remain in this world forever and ever? No. In another place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, innaka mayyitun wa innahum mayyitun. Indeed, you will die. And indeed, they will also die. In three places, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, kullu nafsin dhaiqatul maut. Every soul will taste death. Every soul will taste death. Every soul will have to die. Every living thing will have to die. So much so that all the angels will die one day and they will be resurrected again. Jibreel alayhi salam will die. Israfil alayhi salam will die. Mikail alayhi salam will die. And Malakul Maut, Israel alayhi salam will also die. Kullu shayin halikun illa wajha. Everything will perish except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent us into this world for a limited period of time. And in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that limited period is fixed. We are unaware. Allah knows for how long He has sent me in this world. And Allah knows for how long He has sent you in this world. For how long He has sent you in this world. For how long He has sent you in this world. He is fully aware. And the clock is ticking away. Every second is taking us nearer and nearer to the grave. So one day we will die. We will go in the grave. We will be questioned in the grave. For some, the grave will become a garden from the gardens of paradise. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala include all of us amongst this group. And for some, the grave will become a pit from the pits of hell. May Allah safeguard all of us from being in this group. And after many, many years, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows when Qiyamah will take place, when the trumpet will be blown, Qiyamah will take place. Everything will perish. And only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows for how long the whole creation will remain in that condition. Everything will perish except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows after how long. Who will be resurrected first and thereafter who will be resurrected, who will be resurrected? Because the malaika and the jinns and the humans, all living creatures will perish. وَنُفِخَ فِي السُّورِ فَسَعِكَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ. The trumpet will be blown the first time. And all those people who are in the heavens, who are in the earth, all the living creatures will perish. Except for those whom Allah will desire that they live. According to one opinion of the Mufassirin, these will be certain malaika. certain malaika, certain angels, Jibril, Mikael, Israfil, Israel, they will not die. Upon the blowing of the first trumpet. But thereafter, one by one, they will also will have to face death and they will all die. So a time will come when only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remain. Kullu man alayha fan wa yabqa wajhu rabbika dhul jalali wal ikram. Every person will perish except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And according to one interpretation of the Mufassirin, it is at this point Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask this question, Limanil mulkul yawm? For whom is the sovereignty? Where is Firaun today? Where is Firaun? Who used to say, Ana Rabbukum ul-Ala? Where are the kings? Where are the queens? The sovereigns, where are the presidents and the prime ministers, where are the dictators? Where are those people who used to think that I possess this and I possess that and I am in control of this and I have authority over this? Everything has perished except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah will ask, Limanil mulkul yawm? But there will be no one to give answer to this question. So Allah himself will say, لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ. Sovereignty belongs to only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It belonged to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only when you were alive. And it belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only today when nothing is alive. And when you are resurrected and the people of Jannah will go in Jannah, people of Jahannam will go in Jahannam, even then the sovereignty will belong only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After many, many years, the trumpet will be blown a second time. ثُمَّ نُفِخَ فِيهِ أُخْرَى. Then the trumpet will be blown a second time. فَإِذَا هُمْ قِيَامٌ يَنْظُرُونَ. And suddenly, everybody will be upstanding. Everybody will be resurrected. Yandurun, and they will be looking here and there. Now they are in the field of mahshar. Now the day of judgment is in front of them. Ya waylana man ba'athana min marqadina. Woe to us, may we perish, may we be destroyed, may we not live. Ya waylana, man ba'athana min marqadina, who has resurrected us from our resting place. The horrors of the day of Qiyamah will be so severe in comparison to the punishment of the grave that even the rejecter and the disbeliever will say that in comparison to this day, the grave was a resting place. Ya waylana man ba'athana min marqadina, who has resurrected us from our resting place. The rejectors will say this. So the angels will say on behalf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hadha ma wa'ada ar-Rahman. This is that which Rahman Ta'ala had promised. He had made this promise that a day is going to come when you will be resurrected and when you will be reckoned for everything you do in the world. This is that promise. Allah is fulfilling that promise. هَذَا مَا وَعَدَ الرَّحْمَانِ وَصَدَقَ الْمُرْسَلُونَ. And you did not believe in the messengers, but now you know that the messengers spoke the truth. day of reckoning, the day of judgment. Each and every person will be reckoned. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask 5 questions. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that on the day of Qiyamah, when a person is made to stand in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his feet will not be able to move. That means he will not be given permission to move. And he will not be able to run away either. The son of Adam's feet will not be able to move on the day of Qiyamah until he is asked 5 questions. My friends, my brothers, my daughters, my sisters, my mothers, ponder for a moment. Ponder for a moment. This is not something that other people will have to go through. Each and every one of us will have to go through this stage of reckoning. So let us first worry about ourselves individually. What will happen to me when I am made to stand in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Lot of people have to go and face the judge in the court. Whether they are guilty or not guilty. Whether they are guilty or not guilty. They all have fear. Why do they have fear despite not being guilty? Because they know that the judge is not aware of everything. So it is possible that he may make a wrong judgment. So when a person is guilty, he will fear. And even if he is not guilty, he will fear, because if the judge misunderstands the whole case and gives a judgment against me, then what will happen to me? The guilty one will fear because he knows that there is a great possibility that the judgment will go against me and I will be imprisoned. And the one who is not guilty, he also fears that the judge may make a wrong judgment, and as a result, I will be imprisoned. So they fear the imprisonment. They fear the jail. And it is the court case that will decide the fate. So a person fears the court case. All the associates of the one who has been charged, they also fear the outcome. They turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they give sadaqah, because sadaqah removes calamities. They make dua because dua removes calamities. They ask other people to make dua. Here, my friends, my sisters and daughters, we are discussing the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this world, just as the one who is innocent fears that the judge may make a mistake, similarly the one who is guilty also has some hope that the judge may make a mistake. My lawyer may be able to convince the judge that I am not guilty. There is some hope. In the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the one who is guilty, he has no hope. No hope. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is alim, all-knowing. He is khabir, all-aware. He is basir, all-seeing. He is sami, all-hearing. So he is listening to everything. He is looking at everything. He has knowledge of everything. And he is aware of everything. This is the judge we will be facing. Allahu Akbar. الله أكبر الله أكبر. مالك يوم الدين, يوم الدين, يوم الدين, the day of retribution, the day of retribution. Those people who will do good will be rewarded, and those people who will do bad will be punished. The day of retribution, the day of Qiyamah is the day of retribution. And the sole controller and the possessor of this day is none other than Allah. Maliki Yawmiddin. He is the possessor of the day of retribution. Nobody else has any authority. Ya ayyuhan nasu ittaqu rabbakum. O you who believe, create a barrier between yourselves and the disobedience of your Rabb. Do not disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because a day is going to come. Fear that day. Wakhshaw yawman. Fear that day. La yajzi walidun an waladih wala mauludun huwa jazin an walidihi shay'a. On that day, no child will be able to help its parent, and no parent will be able to help its child. يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ. On that day, a brother, a sister will be running away from the other brother and sister, from siblings. Siblings will run away from siblings. They will not try to help their siblings. They will run away from their siblings. Why? Because I am concerned about myself. Why should I worry about somebody else? I am in trouble myself. يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ. The children will run away from the mother. وَأَبِيهِ. The children will run away from the father. وَصَاحِبَتِهِ. The husband will run away from the wife, and vice versa. وَبَنِي. And the parents will run away from the children. لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَانٌ يُغْنِي. Each and every person will be in a particular condition that day, the worry, concern about himself only. That will make him forget everybody else. Allama ibn Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala, a great mufassir, he quotes a hadith of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wherein our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that each and every Nabi on the day of Qiyamah will be saying, nafsi nafsi, nafsi nafsi, my soul, myself, my life, me, me. Oh Allah, save me. Oh Allah, save me. Oh Allah, save me. I am worried about myself. In this hadith, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in this hadith that is quoted by Allama Ibn Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala, Ibn Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala says that Isa alayhi salatu was salam will be heard saying on the day of Qiyamah. Isa alayhi salam. We are not talking about a pious person, a wali, a Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And not only a Nabi, a Rasul of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasul is of a higher category than Nabi. And from amongst the very, very eminent Rasul, Isa alayhi salatu wassalam, what will he be saying on the day of Qiyamah? He will be saying, nafsi, nafsi, O Allah, I ask you to save me. O Allah, I ask you to save me. La as'aluka illa nafsi. I do not ask you to save anyone other than myself. Not that I am not concerned about anybody else. I may be concerned, but the circumstances are such that I should not involve myself in anything else. Lest Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may question me on that aspect too. Why are you interceding for this person? Do you know who this person is? Do you know what this person has done in regard to my commands? So I don't have the courage to intercede for anybody. La asaluka illa nafsi. I ask you only to save me. And thereafter, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam quotes Isa alayhi salatu wa sallam. Isa alayhi salatu wa sallam, who is quoted to have said in the Quran, who is quoted to have said, وَبَرَّمْ بِوَالِدَتِي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me certain specific qualities. One of them is that I am very kind towards my mother. Especially kind towards my mother. So this Nabi who was given this special quality, that he was more kind and more affectionate towards his mother than everybody else, he will say on the day of Qiyamah, La as'aluka Maryam allati waladatni. Oh Allah, I do not even ask you, and I do not even intercede on behalf of my mother Maryam who has given me birth. Today I am only asking you about myself. So again, I am asking myself first, thereafter all of you sitting here, thereafter all those brothers and sisters who are listening to me far and wide in the country, outside the country, that let us embed this thought in our hearts and minds, that this is a station which we all will have to pass through. We are not talking about Zaid, Amar or Bakr here. We are not talking about Ahmad, Muhammad and Ibrahim. We are talking about them and ourselves. And whenever there is a calamity, we worry about our dear and near ones. But it's human nature that a person worries about himself first. Thereafter his wife, parents and children. Thereafter those who are beloved to him. It's human nature. So we should first worry about ourselves. What will happen to me when I am resurrected on the day of Qiyamah? What will happen to my children? Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you who believe, qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. Save yourselves and save your family members from the fire of Jahannam. So death is inevitable. And at the time of death, nobody will be able to support us. Grave is inevitable. Nobody will be able to support us in the grave. The day of Qiyamah, resurrection is inevitable. Nobody will be able to save us when we are resurrected. The reckoning is inevitable. Nobody will be able to save us when we are made to stand in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this world, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran to our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, there were three ways of saving yourself in this world. There were three ways of saving yourself. One was, my son is guilty. My son is guilty. So I am saying to the king, I am making a plea that please, let him go and punish me on his place. That was one way of saving someone. The son will say to the king that please, my father is guilty, but let my father go and punish me instead of my father. This was one way. The other way was to use influence and intercede on behalf of somebody. Use influence. Write a letter to the king or go and plead to the king. You are a minister, so you will say to the king that please forgive him. He is a good friend of mine. He is my friend's son. And I vouch for him. He will not do it again. This was another way of freeing somebody. And the third way, using power. Using power. Power against the law. Power against the police. Against the court. strong family. Like mafias do. They use their influence, their power. And sometimes if they have to, they will break into the jail and free the person. Three methods, fourth method. Ransom. How much money do you want? How much? 500,000 pounds? 1 million pounds? How much? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the glorious Quran, none of these methods will help a person on the day of Qiyamah. وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا لَا تَجْزِي نَفْسٌ أَن نَفْسٍ شَيْئًا. A person will not be able to replace a person. وَلَا يُقْبَلُ مِنْهَا شَفَاعَةً. A person will not be able to intercede. No influence will be used. وَلَا يُخَذُ مِنْهَا عَدِلَ. Ransom will not be accepted. وَلَا هُمْ يُنْسَرُونَ. And they will not be helped by anybody. No power will be able to help them. What I am trying to emphasize is, may my nafs pay heed to this, and may you all and all those who are listening to me pay heed to this. Let us not become heedless. That we all have to face this situation on the day of Qiyamah. And our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam says that when a person will be resurrected and when he will be reckoned, he will be made to stand in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Laysa baynahu wa baynahu tarjuman. There will be no mediator in between. There will be no translator in between. He himself will have to fight his own case. No lawyer, no attorney, no solicitor, nobody. He himself will have to answer the questions. On this day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask 5 questions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so kind, so kind, so kind that He has already told us what He is going to ask us so that we can prepare accordingly. He has already told us that this is what I am going to ask you. So live your life in a way that answering becomes easy on the day of Qiyamah. He revealed these 5 questions to his beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And his Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us that a human will not be able to move his feet from their place, from their places, until he is asked 5 questions. La tazulu qadama ibn adama yawm al-qiyamati hatta yus'ala an khams. Inshallah, we will discuss these 5 questions in the gathering next week. Let us try to absorb whatever we have listened to thus far today. And inshallah, we will discuss the 5 questions in the gathering next week after the Isha Salat on Tuesday. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the tawfiq. There is a meditation that will help a lot. And that meditation is that a person should sit down once a week and meditate on the day of resurrection and reckoning. The trumpet has been blown and I am being resurrected from the grave. Think about yours. I have been resurrected. And I am looking towards my right, towards my left, in front of me, and I am in the midst of millions of people who are all worried and concerned about themselves. Nobody is concerned and worried about the other. I am also running about here and there. And this will continue for such a long time, and then eventually I will be made to stand in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask me questions. How will I answer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The only way to answer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is for me to better my life by learning deen and following deen. Once a week, if we are able to do this, this self-reckoning, and close your eyes and put yourself in that picture, that I am there on the day of reckoning and I am waiting for my turn to come. How will I answer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? My friends, it will go a long way in bringing positive changes in our lives. Inshallah, we will discuss the remaining hadith and the 5 questions in the coming gathering. May Allah grant us all the tawfiq. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين ربنا اغفر لنا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم يا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم احفظنا من كل بلاء الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم أصلح لنا شأننا كله ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين ولا تنزع منا صالح ما عتيتنا اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى واجعل آخرتنا خيرا من الأولى اللهم زيننا بزينة الإيمان واجعلنا هداة مهتدين اللهم رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا اللهم اجعل حركاتنا وسكناتنا كلها في محبتك وتقواك اللهم لا تؤمنا مكرك ولا تنسنا ذكرك ولا تهتك عنا سترك ولا تجعلنا من الغافلين اللهم اجعل خير أيامنا يوم نلقاك فيه اللهم إنا نعوذ برضاك من سخطك وبعفك من عقابك وبك منك جل وجهك لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك اللهم بيض وجوهنا يوم القيامة ولا تسود وجوهنا يوم القيامة اللهم حاسبنا حسابا يسيرا اللهم حاسبنا حسابا يسيرا اللهم حاسبنا حسابا يسيرا اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك منه نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذ منه نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وأنت المستعان وعليك البلاغ ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.
سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر.